just picked up this cheap Schwinn. It was like 150 bucks or something, which is nice because, you know, in LA, I'd always have a good bike so I could tool around and take photos, because if you drive around or Uber around, well, Ubering around doesn't make sense to take photos because you'd spend 100 bucks in a day. In driving around, you might spend that as well because you have to find a place to park. So here I figured, oh, I've been running everywhere, but you can only get so far when you're running. And so I decided to pick up this bike yesterday, and you know, I'm going to go on a photo shoot journey. I just needed to raise the handlebars up a little bit. So here we go. I guess this will be a little bumpy, but that's okay. So this is a bike path that runs into Minneapolis. I don't know how far it goes. It may go much farther than I think, but it's a really nice bike path. Okay, I'm at this nice park and I thought I would film. I had been filming a little tutorial for a friend so he can get the best audio out of what he's working with. And right now I'm just using this little thing called the Smart Lav from Rode. It's a fantastic little mic. And so right now I just have it plugged into my iPhone. I mean, that's how it operates. And then there's an app and then you just record right off the iPhone. So I think this is going out to Dustin, but I figured it'd be good for the vlog too. I just have my bike set up and then the camera sitting on my bike seat with a little tripod. And so it's working. I mean, it must be 110 feet away, I suppose. I have a 50 millimeter lens on an A6000. So the little Sony works so well when you're out, you know, just casual shooting. It's just a fantastic little camera for, well, really for a lot of things, but this especially. Now, I don't know if I'm in focus, to be honest, but this is more of an audio thing. So, Dustin, I hope you like this. So, my friend Dustin's using the GoPro to do these training videos, but the audio he's using is off the GoPro. So, I figure if he uses this Smart Lav for 79 bucks, it will solve the audio issue, and I'm sure he'll be able to tell that. And if any of you are audiophiles, perhaps you'll be into this too. For the rest of you, maybe I should have told you to skip over this section. So there's this clip with Steve Wynn that I like a lot. So he'd said,
we don't really hustle people to gamble. As a matter of fact, we're rather standoffish about it. What we do say is, if it happens to be that you like to play a slot machine or a shoot crap or baccarat or roulette or any of those games, come here. The experience will be more elegant. The service will be classier and better. The food will taste better. We will, if you want to stay at a great hotel, this is the place. And you can surely gamble while you're here. Or you don't gamble at all. Just bring your credit card and pay for it, because we charge for stuff.
Now, that's how I operate in my life. Obviously, I don't sell gambling, but I sell high-end services. And I actively dissuade people from hiring me, because sometimes it's just not the right fit. And I know that if we work together, they'll be difficult. We don't see the same vision, or perhaps they won't let me be me. Like when earlier I was, I think yesterday I alluded to how Steve Jobs, you know, he said, why would I hire smart people and then tell them what to do? I hire smart people to tell me what to do. And oftentimes I'll get people who are such amateurs that what they think looks good is not what looks good. Their taste, their sort of stylistic taste buds haven't been developed yet. But when I do take on a client, all I ask for is that they bring their money, because I do charge for stuff, and I charge plenty. And I'm proud of that, because I've worked up my skill level for so long, and I don't have hobbies, right? I don't go to a dart league or a bowling league or a softball league. This is what I do all the time. You know, and I hang out with my girlfriend, Mallory, obviously. And a part of, you know, we're doing this vlog together, which is a fun little way to accomplish two things at once. It enhances our lives a lot doing this vlog, to be honest. But in response to the no pool league, no dart league, I'd once made a video about that right here.
When you're taking your kids to Little League, when you're at soccer practice, when you're out for lattes with the girls, or you're out for beers with the guys, know that there's somebody out there working, constantly working while you're doing other things, the things you call living your life. You always knew, there was always a figment of your imagination that knew that there was someone out there, that each time that you were living your life away from your business, that person is working. I'm that man. While you're living your life, I'm reading, I'm writing, I'm thinking, I'm working. You may say, what kind of life is that? Maybe to you that's no life at all. That's why you'll always lose.
It was late and I was in one of those loopy states of mind at 3 a.m. And I, you know, it was kind of an egotistical rant. I was a little upset at people demanding my time without wanting to give the money. And so I just went off on that little rant. And a person made a song about it.
I'm constantly working while you're doing other things. Things you call living your life. You always knew, there was always a figment of your imagination that knew that there was someone out there. That person is working. I'm that man. While you're living your life, I'm reading, I'm writing, I'm thinking, I'm working. You may say, what kind of life is that? That's why you always lose. I'm constantly working while you're doing other things.
On that note,